When working with fillets, especially in cases where three or more edges converge, it can be a challenge to get the fillets to blend together nicely. In this particular example, we have three converging edges. This is how it looks after applying the fillets. You can see that this segment of the fillet sort of curves downwards. The area where the fillets converge also looks very fragmented. We want to achieve a more natural looking transition like so. The method that I am about to show here should be used as a last resort. We should always try our best to reorder or resize the fillets. We might even have to consider moving the edges involved. However, due to certain design constraints, it is not always possible to do so. I first learnt of this method from a video by DiMonte Group, which was demonstrated in SolidWorks. I will attempt to replicate the same workflow inside Fusion 360. The main issue in this case is that the design calls for different fillet values. We have relatively large fillets along these two edges. And we need a small fillet along these edges. The difference in size makes it difficult to achieve a smooth blend with the standard fillet tool. To solve this problem, we need a way to stop the fillet at certain points. We can achieve this either by splitting the body or by providing a stopping face. I will leave a link to the example file. You can download this to follow along. We will extrude a simple block of material to provide us with the stopping faces. Start a sketch on this face. Create a rectangle with one corner snapped to this edge, and the other corner snapped to this tangent edge. Begin a midpoint constraint, and make the midpoint of the left side of the rectangle coincide with this vertex. We want the top face of the block to coincide with the tangent edge of the 5mm fillet later. So dimension the block accordingly. In this case, I will dimension from this edge. Use this rectangular profile to begin an extrude. I'm going to extrude this to an arbitrary value for the moment. We will be adjusting this later. It is important to make sure that the block merges with the existing solid. So set the operation to join. With this block, we can apply different fillets independently without Fusion trying to blend the fillets for us. I'm going to apply a 5mm fillet on these edges. You can compare this to the original fillet without the block. With the block, we have stopped the fillet from propagating to the front and prevented the downward sloping segment. Begin a new fillet and apply a 2mm fillet to these edges. The block stops the 2mm fillets from converging with the 5mm fillets. For the best result, we want the block to terminate up against this tangent edge here. Let's begin the measure tool and measure the distance between this face and the tangent edge. We can now go back into the extrude and apply the same value. Now we need to find a way to get rid of the block. First, we need to split the front face of the block. Create a sketch on this face. Because these two faces are at different angles, these two fillets do not exactly line up. We will start a feed point spline snap the spline to these two points. Add a tangent relation between the spline and the adjacent edges. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the spline. Activate the Surface tab. Control select these faces. And press the Delete key. The solid becomes a surface with an opening. We can already start to visualize how the final surface is going to look like. It is possible to use a single patch surface to patch up this opening. However, for the best result, we should try to minimize the area that the patch surface needs to cover. There is an opportunity here to use a loft. Go to Create, Loft. We shall loft from this edge to this edge. For both continuity options, set to tangent and align to surface so that the lofted surface will be tangent to the adjacent faces. Click on the arrow for rails and select this edge. Set this to tangent also. Go to Create, Patch. Remove the Enable Chaining option. Select the chain of edges that bound the opening. Group the edges together and set to tangent. At this moment, this is still a hollow surface body. Go to Modify, Stitch. Box select all the surfaces and stitch them together into a solid.